Welcome students. Today we will study lens chapter of paper 1. Before we begin to the lesson, we'll just discuss the learning objectives and the keywords of today's topic. First we'll discuss what is lens, what are the types of lenses, and the lenses are double convex, planar convex and concavo convex for convex lens. Concave lens, double concave, planar concave and convexo concave. The concepts related to the lens: center of curvature of the lens, radius of curvature of the lens, principal axis, focus and focal length. We learn only this much today. I repeat, the type of lenses and the terms related to lens. What is a lens? The lens is a transparent medium bounded by two spherical surfaces. So if you have a sphere, another sphere over here, the union or the intersection of these two spheres will form a lens. The first sphere will have a center of curvature. The center of the sphere named as C1, the center of the next sphere named as C2. So here we see two curved surfaces. In general, we call it as convex lens. What is the peculiarity of it? At the middle, it is thicker. At the edge, it is thinner. This is the edge and this is the center. Thick over here and thin over here. Coming to convex lens, we can further classify it as double convex lens. So both the sides are bulged out. The next is one side is plain and the other is bulged out, which will be called as plano. We start reading from the right here, plano convex lens. Then we come across concavo. So this is inward. And over here is bulged out, named as concavo convex lens. I repeat, intersection of the two spheres having centers C1 and C2 will give us a lens. And the lens formed over here is convex lens. Convex lens can further be classified as double convex, where both the edge surfaces are bulging out. Then plano convex, where one side is plain and the other is bulging out. The last one is concavo convex, where one side is inward surface and the other is the outward surface. Same thing same type of formation in case of concave lens, where we have one sphere with center C1 and another one with center C2. If I take these two parts, for this surface, the curvature is C2. For this surface, the curvature is C1. We get a concave lens. So we are taking two lenses, only one part here and one part here. this sphere or this curve is a part of a sphere having center C1. This is a part of another sphere having center C2. So the two arcs are taken out and you get a concave lens. Both the surfaces are inward, so we call it as double concave lens. If one surface is plane and the other surface is inward, then you call this as plano concave lens. Plano concave lens. The next one is one side or one surface bulged out and the other surface inward. This will be convexo concave. So we come across the terms that we discussed so far. What is a lens? It is a made of transparent medium. Then type of lenses, convex and concave. General classification. Convex are three types: double convex, plano convex, concave convex. For concave lens, double concave, plano concave, convexo concave. We differentiate the convex and concave lens based on its appearance. At the center, the convex lens is thick. At the edge, the convex lens is thin. Here at the center for concave, the center is thin and the edge is thick. This is for your identification. Given the lens, you can feel and then identify whether the given lens is convex or concave. Coming to the concepts regarding each lens or the parts of the lens, you can say. The very first one we asked is we discussed that the lens is made of two spheres. So, what is center of curvature of a lens? These are the centers of the spheres of which the lens is a part. So for the first sphere, C1 is the center. This sphere is a part of this lens. C2 is the next center of curvature, means center of the sphere of which the lens is a part. So C1 and C2 are the centers of curvature. What is radii of curvature? You take this distance, taken as sphere, the center is C1, radius is R1. The radius of the sphere of which the lens is a part is called the radius of curvature. So how many spheres are involved in the formation of a lens? Two spheres. It will have two centers. The lens will have, therefore, for this part of the lens, the C1 comes here. This part of the lens where the sphere was on the other side, the C2. Therefore, we have C1 and C2, two centers of curvature for the lens. Similarly, radii of curvature, radius of the first one and the radius of the second one. It need not be the same. Why? We have a bigger sphere with center C1 and radius R1. We have the next sphere C2 and the radii is R2. R1 need not be equal to R2. I hope the concept is clear now. Two centers of curvature for each lens, two radii of curvature for each lens. Now we come across the principal axis. It is an imaginary line that will pass through the two centers of curvature. So this is the sphere, the next sphere is this. You have the first center as C1 and the second center as C2. The imaginary line passing through C1 and C2 is known as principal axis. In case of what happens if a ray of light passes from a rarer medium to a denser medium? We studied this in 9th standard. That is, I take a point, I draw the normal. A ray of light, this is the incident ray. The medium we assume as air, therefore this is the rarer medium. This is glass, another transparent medium but denser than air. So this is the denser medium. The ray of light enters the denser medium from air to glass here. And this is the normal. Angle formed between the normal and the incident ray is known as angle of incidence. Due to refraction, and what is refraction then? The change in the direction. The phenomenon by which the incident ray, when passes from a rarer medium to a denser medium, changes its direction, and the angle formed between the normal and the incident ray is known as angle of incidence. Angle between the normal and the refracted ray. This is refracted ray. The ray where the direction changes is the point of incidence. This phenomenon of change in the direction of the light, when light passes from a rarer medium to a denser medium at the point of incident, is known as refraction. So in case of lens, the incident ray, this is our imaginary line C1, C2, which is a principal axis, the midpoint of the lens is known as optic center, and the characteristic of this optic center is that we consider an incident ray. This ray, without any deviation, here we discussed air and the next is glass, which is denser. So light ray passing from rarer medium to the denser medium is supposed to change its direction, and the phenomenon of refraction happened there. Whereas in this case, if it is directed towards this particular point on the principal axis, which is the center of the lens, the incident ray moves out or come out without any deviation. The peculiarity, this is incident ray and this is our refracted ray. But no refraction, no deviation. This particular point, which is the center of the lens, where the incident ray moves out without any deviation in its direction, is known as the optic center. The next point is, when the ray of light, we consider here a parallel beam of light, taking the lens, convex lens. So we have C1 and C2. We consider set of parallel rays. refraction because this is not passing through the optics and this will undergo refraction over here. And in case of convex lens, it bends like this. From here, changes its direction. These two meet at a point, or we can say converge at a point. At a point. And where does this point? On the principal axis. This point is known as the principal focus. F is the principal focus. Of the lens. So here we have O. This distance between O to F will be the focal length of the lens. So we came across the focal length. Focus lies on the principal axis. That is the point where the incident rays converge after refraction. The lens can have the incident ray from this side. Now we drew from the left, we will draw from the right and see what happens. The lens, the principal. We consider a set of rays coming, entering the lens like this, which will change its direction, deviate. This ray also will change its direction, deviate, but they converge at a point here. So how many foci for a lens? Two. One, depending upon where the incident ray enter the lens. So one will be F1 and the other will be F2. Everything on the right is considered F2 and this will be F1. Next. And so here, again, and this OF1 is called the focal length of the lens. The peculiarity of convex lens: after refraction, the incident rays converge at a point. Therefore, convex lens is otherwise known as converging lens. Converging lens. Another characteristic, or by appearance, we can say thick at the center. Thin at the edge. Instead of convex, if it is concave, let us see whether they converge or diverge. We have the concave lens now. This is the imaginary lens and optical center or optic center O. Consider a set of parallel lines. Basically, what will happen? This will diverge, move away from the principal axis C1 and C2. But when we view from here, we feel that this ray had started from here. It appears to begin from here. That's our perception. We feel so. So, for the same thing, in this case also, this ray also appears to diverge from a point on the principal axis. This is F1. The focus of concave lens lies on the principal axis. The point on the principal axis from where we feel the refracted ray emerges from is known as the focus, that is F1. The same way, if we had the set of rays coming from the other side of the lens. That is here, set of rays, here and others. What happens? It gets in and diverges. This is the refracted ray and this is the incident ray. Here also incident ray gets in and refracts like this. So refracted. But it appears to diverge. We don't feel that it's coming out from here. We feel that it's coming from here. This is the effect. Therefore, since it diverges, convex lens is known as diverging lens. Concave lens is diverging lens. Appearance wise, thin at the center, and thick at the edges. I hope you understood today's lesson. Since we have completed our concept explanation, we will discuss now how you have to prepare yourself for the examination. The questions that you may get for the exam, I will just discuss. You will have to write down this in your notebook after reading the content from your textbook at least 3 to 4 times. In your textbook, the content is explained on page number 80 and 81. Please note down the questions. The first question in your examination. We don't have a question paper, but we have an activity sheet. So the questions that are asked will be based on your understanding and skill. The very first question, which constitute 1 mark, will be what is a lens? Second, you are given a number of pictures like this. A, B, C, D, E, and F. The question paper has this. The question that may ask is, name, observe the given diagrams. Given lenses. So the first one is double convex, second is plano convex, third is double concave, fourth is plano concave, the fifth is convex or concave, and the last is concave or convex. Next question is to draw a cross section of the convex lens and name the parts. So what is a cross section? We already discussed that it's made of 2 spheres. So you have this. The first sphere has a center. You will name it as C1. Second sphere, the center, you will label as C2. Below that, you will write C1 and C2. What are they? Centers of curvature. You will mark the lens, shade it, and you get the lens. You can label the lens if you want as A, B. Then connect the center to the periphery of each sphere and label it as R1 and R2. So you get R1 and R2 radii of curvatures. The other terms, C1, C2, what is this? An imaginary line. C1, C2, principal axis. Let us proceed to optic center and focal length. So, draw a diagram, draw an appropriate diagram to show optic center of a lens. Draw the lens. You can use your protractor or compasses to draw that so that you get the symmetric figure, and it should be symmetric and thin. Mark the center. Where does the optic center lie? Always on the principal axis. C1, C2. Mark this as O. Now, how do you identify that this is the point? You draw an incident ray directed towards the optic center and label it as incident ray. So the arrow indicates that it's directed towards the optic center, and without any deviation it passes through the point, and write this as a refracted ray. Below that you can write O, optic center. Next is for the concave lens. So you draw a concave lens now. Label the point of intersection of the lens, vertical midline, and principal axis. Same way, draw a ray directed towards the optic center, label it as incident ray. Once it come out from the optic center or through the optic center, we see that there is no deviation and label it as refracted ray. Here again, O, optic center. We will now discuss a given reason that convex lens is known as converging lens. You can explain this with a diagram first, and you can write the sentences required. We have O here, we have F1, double of that will be 2F1, or on the other side F2 and it should be taken on a ruler, 2 cm to the left from the optic center, 4 cm to the left will be 2F1, same way to the right, 2 cm to the right from optic center, denote it as F2, and 4 cm on the right side from the optic center, label it as 2F2. I consider 2 parallel rays. After refraction, we will see that it converges and passes through F2. So it's meeting at a point. This point on the principal axis, where the incident ray parallel to the principal axis converges, is known as the focus of the convergence. And since the incident ray after refraction converges on principal axis, we call it as a converging lens. You will refer the textbook to write the answer for this. Light rays parallel to the principal axis, falling on a convex lens, come together, get focused at a point, and hence the convex lens is known as converging lens. So you'll write the answer along with this diagram. The next is concave lens. Is known as diverging lens. Give reasons. So we draw a concave lens now. Identify the point optic center O, then F1. Double distance will be 2F1, same way on the right side, F2 and 2F2. Select 2 parallel incident rays. These rays will diverge after refraction. Label it as incident ray before refraction and after diverging or after refraction. We get 2 rays moving away from the principal axis, label them as refracted rays. But it appears to diverge from a point on the principal axis, and that point is known as the focus. Since it diverges after refraction, since the incident rays parallel to the principal axis diverges after refraction, we call the concave lens as a diverging lens or divergent lens. Other questions that you can get from this content are, define the following terms for which you need to know center of curvatures. Define center of curvature, radii of curvature, principal axis of lens. Focus of concave lens. Focus of convex lens. Focal length of convex lens. Focal length of concave lens. These answers, what all we discussed, you should write in your notebook so that it's easy for you to revise and you get a better understanding. And Mary Benny, I enjoyed delivering this lecture to you. Hope you too enjoy. Thank you, sir.